I think that we can all agree that since Sir Alex Ferguson left Manchester United way back when, things haven't exactly gone to plan for United. It's now been 4 years since they actually won a trophy, and that was 4 years ago in the Europa League. But when you do take a look at United's squad, you would put them with the elite tier teams. But by the end of today's video, we're going to be making Manchester United the best team in the world and bringing them back to the glory days of Sir Alex Ferguson. Make sure you tell me in the comment section down below what team you want me to rebuild next. You guys seem to be really enjoying these videos more than any other that I'm actually doing. That's why I'm trying to make as many of these as possible for you guys. And as always, if you do go on to enjoy today's video, be sure to leave a like and smash that subscribe button. It really does help out with the YouTube algorithm. And if you haven't already seen one of my rebuild video, here are the rules. The main objective of the video is to win the Champions League. I can make any transfers that I want with the given transfer budget. Every single game must be simulated, but the final of the Champions League has to be played. If you take a look at United's starting 11, it is pretty goddamn good as well. You got Cavani, Bruno Fernandes, Rashford, Greenwood, Wan-Bissaka, you got all these ballers, not to mention Pogba and De Gea on the bench. It's a very good team. There's certain elements to improve, don't get me wrong, but it's United, so I don't think we're going to be short on funds. When I said I didn't think we were going to be short on funds, I did not think we were going to get 166.6 million to spend. Jeez. Okay, that's made this a lot easier in my mind, because he's one player that I do want to sign for this transfer window, at least. We all know how heavily linked Jadon Sancho's been to Manchester United for a couple of seasons now, so I felt it was fitting to make him our very first signing of this rebuild. He cost us £160.7 million. I'm pretty sure that's the most expensive signing since starting this rebuild series. 20 years of age, 87 rated. The guy's just a baller. I mean, what else can we say about him? We sold our first player in Juan Mata. Wolfsburg paid 11.3 million for him. He just isn't going to fit the team, but he's been a phenomenal player. He's had an amazing career, but it's time to let him go. We sent out Twanzabi on a two-year loan move to Real Sociedad. It's just to bolster his overall. I mean, Sociedad are a decent team and he'll fit in nicely at their team for the time being. He'll hopefully come back a much better player and he'll be a decent sub for us in the future. We've just made another signing, David Alaba, the Austrian from Bayern Munich. He cost us £30 million exactly, 83 rated, 28 years of age. He's just there to bolster the defence, to be honest. He's going to slot nicely into the starting 11 team alongside Harry Maguire. It was a much needed upgrade in the defensive role, but I feel like we've got enough strength now to push for trophies. We've officially come to the end of the first transfer window in Season 1, and this is how the team is looking. Personally, I'm liking the way that this team is lining up. Rashford and Sancho have already gone up. Fernandes as well has gone up. We put Van de Beek in the team because he's criminally underrated in real life and he never gets a chance. So under me, he's getting a shot in the starting lineup. We've got Alaba and Maguire as our two centre partnerships. Wan-Bissaka and Shaw are going to be brilliant in my opinion. Personally for me, I think we've got a good chance of winning the Champions League in the first season. This could be quite a short video, to be honest. So it's official, we're in the group of death in the Champions League. Take a look at who we are up against. PSG, RB Leipzig and Besiktas. Those teams are insane. Well, Besiktas, I'm not too sure, but RB Leipzig and PSG, they're going to be difficult to overthrow. I'm hoping that we can go through in the group stage. We have yet to get knocked out of the Champions League in the group stage, and I'm hoping that this isn't the day we break that record. Would you take a look at how we have done in Group H? We went undefeated. We won 4, drew 2, won absolutely no games. We absolutely stormed the group stage. The question is, who are we playing in the round of 16? I swear on my life, we have a thing of playing against Juventus in the Champions League. Every single rebuild video, I'm pretty sure we played against them at some point. We play against Juve in the round of 16 in the Champions League. Realistically, that is going to be a very, very tough game. Guys, what is going on? We're absolutely storming the Premier League. We're 5 points clear of second-placed Arsenal. We played 21 games, won 15, drawn 5, and lost only one game all season. That is mental. I genuinely did not expect this. I thought there was a bit more improvement to make in the defensive roles, but clearly they're all right. We've just come to the end of the second transfer window in Season 1. Just take a look at the team, guys. Everyone is doing bits. Van de Beek has gone from 81 to 84 in just half a season. I am buzzing with that. My faith in him has been repaid and then some. Look at the team, boys. Honestly, I've got a good feeling about this year. I mean, never say never, but could this be a one-season rebuild where we win the Champions League in one season? I mean, We never know. I mean, we did it with a worse team with Marseille, so who knows? Now time for the first leg of the Champions League round of 16 tie against Juventus. The team is looking stacked, I can't lie to you. They put so many players in so many weird positions. Rabiot is not a winger, but nevertheless, we move. Can we get an advantage going into the second leg? Come on, United, pull this one out of the bag for us, please. That is not a good start. We lose 3-2. We do have two away goals, but I mean, it's not the best thing in the world. Hopefully in the home leg, we can absolutely annihilate them. We go into the second leg of the round of 16 tie against Juve in the Champions League. 3-2 down on aggregate with one of our best players out on suspension. So Mason Greenwood does take Marcus Rashford's place on the left-hand side of the field. I'm getting a sense of deja vu here, guys. In the Marseille rebuild in season one, we got knocked out in the exact same spot of the video against Juventus. I don't want this to happen again. Come on, boys. Come on, United. Pull this one out the bag for us. Oh, for God. No, it's happened again, boys. It's happened again. We've gone out in the round of 16 against bloody Juve again. Oh, you can't write this, man. That's so annoying. I thought we had the squad quality to pull this one out of the bag, but we don't. We lose 5-3 on aggregate against Juventus, against arguably a weaker team, but ugh, we move. Considering how we crashed out of the Champions League, we've done bits in the Premier League. We've won the Premier League by 6 points. Boys, we've done bits here, guys. I can't even lie to you right now. We've done unreal in the season one. We crashed out of the FA Cup in dramatic fashion in round three, losing to bloody Blackburn of all teams. We lost 2-0 in round three. Like, what is that? We went out in the quarterfinals of the Carabao Cup against our biggest rivals, Manchester City. We lost 4-3 on penalties in the end. Yeah, that's a bit disappointing, not going to lie to you. In the Europa League, PSG take it home, beating Leicester City only 2-1. That's a very poor performance from PSG considering it's Leicester City. No disrespect to Leicester though, but when you compare the two teams, PSG are far and beyond better. What a game the Champions League final turned out to be. It ended 4-3 to Bayern Munich against Borussia Dortmund. Good God, Dortmund can never get a win over Bayern, can they? I'll tell you something, boys. Bruno Fernandes proving why he is one of the best players in the world. 37 games in the Premier League, 20 goals and 4 assists. That's mental. But overall, he got 27 goals and 4 assists in 54 games. Rashford got 23 and 2 and 53. Sancho got 14 and 15 and 53. Van de Beek coming through, 11 goals, 3 assists in 51 games. Martial had a very poor season, only 9 goals and 6 assists when he's a striker. That's poor showing, that is. I'm not going to lie to you. The boys, I mean, we won the Premier League, I suppose. That's not too bad. Wan-Bissaka shot right up. So did Jadon. To be honest, so did a lot of people. Marcus Rashford went up 5 this season. So it was a really good season in terms of overall growth. But yeah, on to season 2 we go. Guys, we're in season 2. I cannot believe how much money the board have allocated us. £320.1 million. I'm winning the Champions League this season. If I don't, I am the worst rebuild YouTuber on this platform, without question. It is happening this season, I don't care. We made our first signing, the absolute baller, Matthijs de Ligt from Juve. The Dutch centre-back is 86 overall, 21 years of age. He cost us £141.4 million. This guy, in my opinion, give him some time. I genuinely believe he's going to be one of the best centre-backs in the world. Joining the Dutch centre-back is Kalidou Koulibaly from Napoli, 30 years of age, 88 rated still. I've got a feeling that this guy is going to maintain that overall for a couple of years yet. We bought him for £84 million. I would say that is good money well spent. But there's one more signing that I want to make, and I've saved the best till last. Manchester United fans, I present to you Cristiano Ronaldo. You guys have been wanting this guy back for years now, and I've finally done it for you guys. 36 years of age, 90 overall. He only cost us £52 million, which I was quite shocked about considering it was Ronaldo. But the guy's an absolute legend. He's one of the greatest footballers of all time, never mind this generation, of all time. And he's come back to Manchester United. It would be quite poetic if we won the Champions League in season 2 with Ronaldo. It'd just be written in the stars. I've got some catching up for you guys to do. So, Bailly and Lindelof have been sold. Bailly for 21.5 million and Victor Lindelof for 31.5 million. We've got too many centre backs, and these guys were the worst of the bunch, so I've just offloaded them as well and got a good amount of money for them as well. I'm thinking about buying a midfielder. I'm not too sure who to buy yet, but I'm sure at some point I will figure out who I want. In my opinion, we've just bought one of the consistently best players in the goddamn world. N'Golo Kante, 30 years of age, 88 rated. We bought him for 77.3 million. This guy is just an absolute monster. I think this guy was the last part of the puzzle in winning the Champions League this year. Okay, more people sold. Cavani has been sold for 11.5 million with the signing of Cristiano Ronaldo. Martial's the backup striker now. Ronaldo's the starting striker. Cavani's dramatically decreasing overall, so it's time for him to leave. Matic has been sold for 12.8 million purely because the midfield has been overloaded. We need to offload some players, and Matic is getting on a bit now, so he wasn't going to fit in the team at all. First transfer window of season 2 has officially come to a close. I personally think we've done absolutely unreal. Take a look at how the squad is looking, guys. We've done absolute bits. We've got Ronaldo back home. We've got Kante, Koulibaly, De Ligt. Guys, it's a Champions League winning team this is. I don't care what anybody says. I've got a very good feeling about this season. A very, very good feeling. We're in Group P of the group stage of the Champions League this season. I'm not going to lie to you. If we do not win every single game in Group E, there is something wrong. The only team that's going to trouble us is RB Leipzig. Spartak Moscow have got no chance. PAOK have got absolutely no chance. Realistically, we should annihilate every single one of them. Let's see how we do. 3, 2, 1. Boys and girls, we've absolutely smashed it. 4 wins, 2 draws. I'm a bit disappointed we didn't go 6 wins out of 6. But nevertheless, we are through to the round of 16. Hopefully not against Juve this time. Wow, we're against Sevilla. That's going to be a tricky game. They've got some very good players they have. Unless they've sold them, I'm not too sure. But nevertheless, we're playing against Sevilla in the round of 16 in the Champions League. In the Premier League, it's not looking so good for us in comparison to this time last season. We're 10 points behind first place. First place of all people are Spurs. What in God's name is going on there? The bottle jobs of bloody England are actually winning the Premier League at the minute. What is going on? Fair play. Looks like we're going to have to replay round 3 of the FA Cup because we draw 2-2 of all teams against bloody Cardiff. Like, that just... FIFA doesn't make sense sometimes, does it? We're in the semi-finals against Arsenal in the Carabao Cup. Oh my God, I want us to win that. The thing is, just because it's Arsenal, I want us to win it. I don't care. I just want us to beat Arsenal. We've come to the end of the second transfer window in Season 2. We bought nobody because, quite frankly, take a look at the goddamn team. Who can we buy that will fit in this team? Our start 11 is stacked. Our subs bench is absolutely stacked as well. I mean, where can we improve this team? Yeah, maybe we can buy someone instead of Luke Shaw. But, like, who would you get? Like, let's be honest. Where would you improve this team? There is no one you can buy to improve this team. It's now time for the Champions League, guys. We're in the round of 16. The first leg away from home against Sevilla. I mean, I'm so confident going into this. Like, we should really do bits against Sevilla. I mean, like, look at our team in comparison to theirs. Navas is aging. Suso's aging. Konate is a good player, don't get me wrong. And Nesiri, I'm not even sure what his overall would be. Acampus, I know he's getting on a bit. But, guys, honestly, come on. We've got to pull something out of the bag against Sevilla. Surely still on. Let's see the W. Is that it? 1-0. But to be fair, according to the stats, we do dominate the game. Let's go on to the second leg. It's now time for our home leg in the round of 16 against Sevilla. We do have an away goal advantage against these guys. We should seal the deal here, guys. We should seal the deal. Come on. Let's get ourselves into the quarterfinals. Yes, we're into the quarterfinals. The mental thing is, though, they didn't even have a shot in the entirety of this tie. They did not have a single shot. Go back in the video and have a look. I promise you I'm right. On to the quarterfinals we go. Would you take a look at who we're playing in the quarterfinals? Bloody Bayern Munich, the absolute powerhouses of German football themselves. We go into this game with one of our best players out. Kalidou Koulibaly has picked up a suspension, so Harry Maguire takes his place. I'm not going to lie to you, that does put me a little bit at worry because Koulibaly is one of our best defenders. But nevertheless, we go into this game with strong hopes that we can pull, just do something against Bayern. Come on, United, we've got the team, let's do something. Yes! Oh my god. Oh, come on! We pulled off a 2-1 away leg win against Bayern Munich in the quarters. That is promising as hell. On to the second leg we go. It's now time for the second leg against Bayern Munich. We're 2-1 up on aggregate with two away goals. Kalidou Koulibaly makes his return to the squad. I'm ready. The players are ready. Let's book ourselves a place in the semi-finals. Come on, United. Let's do it. Yes! We convincingly batter the Germans. On to the semi-finals we go. Can we possibly get any tougher opponents? We're up against Barcelona in the semi-finals. And Mason Greenwood's got to take Marcus Rashford's place again because he's suspended. So we're a man down there, realistically. Their squad looks insane. Actually, no, taking a proper look at it, their centre-back lineup doesn't look strong at all. They've got Griezmann, Milinkovic-Savic, Gundogan, De Jong, they're solid. Firpo's all right. Marlon's a good player. Dembele's quite good on career mode. But realistically, we should beat these guys. Let's hope that with the home advantage that we can do bits against them. We do as well. We take a 2-1 advantage going into the second leg. Come on, United. Our players just love getting themselves suspended, don't they? This time, it is Wan-Bissaka who's got suspended. So we put Alex Telles in his place. This game could realistically go either way. Barcelona have the home advantage. They've got Messi back in the team. But their back three, again, it's not the strongest. Tarkowski, Rudiger and Lenglet. That's not the strongest back three, if I'm being totally honest. Especially when our front three is Rashford, Ronaldo and Sancho. We're 2-1 up on aggregate as well. Can we book our place in the finals? Come on, United. Can we do it? We're in the finals. Come on! Get in there, boys. Season 2, we're in the finals of the Champions League. In Season 2, we're bringing it home. Come on! Would you take a look at who we're playing in the final? Manchester City, the Manchester Derby takes place in the Champions League final, the grandest stage of them all. But before we get into this game, let's take a look at how we've done this season. We do end up finishing second in the league in the Premier League. Spurs somehow take the top spot with 10 points clear of us as well. They finish on 94 points. Fair play to Spurs. They didn't bottle it this year, but they probably bottle it the year after. Tottenham Hotspur go on to win the FA Cup as well. Jesus Christ. Brighton were in the final as well, but a fair play to Brighton though for getting to the final. That was no easy task. Oh, you've got to be kidding me. They've beaten us in the Carabao Cup final as well. You can't write this stuff, honestly. Well, that does mean that we beat Arsenal in the semi-finals. Let's just have a little quick one. Oh my God, we beat them 7-0. I love it, I love it, I love it. Have that, Arsenal. But yeah, fair play to Spurs. They've run away with it this year. That's the treble, isn't it, I believe? Milan take the Europa League against Borussia Mönchengladbach. They beat them 1-0 in the Europa League final. Fair play to the Italians for bringing it home. Even though Ronaldo's gone down 2 overall, he is the top goalscorer. I mean, he's just insane, isn't he? 59 games played, 29 goals, 2 assists. Marcus Rashford with 25 goals, 8 assists. Bruno Fernandes, 23 goals, 13 assists. Jadon Sancho, 11 goals, 10 assists. And then everything else after that's pretty bog standard. But boys, De Ligt went up to 90 as well. 4 overall increase. Guys, the boys have done bits this year. Wow, I can't get over that. Boy, I tell you what, it just shows that if United actually had some direction with their transfers, they could genuinely be one of the best teams in the world. It's now time for the Champions League final. Take a look at their team. De Bruyne, Rodri, Sterling, Immobile, Ferran, Torres. I'm not too sure who Kabore is. Ruben Diaz, Akai, whatever his name is. Zinchenko, Fernandinho, Edison. It's a very, very good team. I'm not going to lie to you. But our team is just as good, if not better. It's going to be a tough game. It's going to be a dirty game. It's going to be the Manchester Derby. Let's get into the Champions League final. Oh no. Oh no. Oh no. No, 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 no. No. Yes, De Ligt is straight in there. We've got the ball with Sancho. He's running down the wing. He's running down the wing. What can we do? Can we find Ronaldo? Ronaldo. Ronaldo's going to use that pace. He's going to use that pace. 38 years of age. And he makes it 1-0 to Manchester United in the Champions League final in the 13th minute against Manchester City. So, what a goal. I tell you what, 38 years of age, he has still got it. Look at him just leave the defence for dead. Come on, the boys. It is 1-0 to United in the Champions League final. Bruno Fernandes, he finds Ronaldo. Ronaldo, oh my God. Can he make it to... Oh, Aki just keeps up with him. Maybe he's not as fast as he used to be, fair play. But has he still got a leap on him? Has he still got a leap? He does! Oh my God! Ronaldo up like a salmon, makes it 2-0 in 5 minutes. Oh my God, what a crossing from Bruno Fernandes from the corner. But what a header from Ronaldo. Let's just take another look at this. The corner, he goes straight to the front post, and Ronaldo beats everybody in the air. Edison just doesn't stand a chance, and it is 2-0 in the Champions League final, just like that. Oh no, oh no. Oh, no, 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 no. Oh, my God. Just like that, it's 2-1. That was the worst defending I've ever seen from me. Jesus Christ, what was I doing? Rodri, of all players, just caught... Like, look at this. I mean, what was I doing there? That is just dreadful defending from me. De Gea should be doing better there, realistically. But nevertheless, it's 2-1 now. Game on. What can he do? Can he find Ronaldo? Ronaldo, he's through. Can he get his hat trick? Can he get his hat trick? Oh my God, he's just done it in the cheekiest way humanly possible. He dinks Edison to get his hat trick, to make it 3-1 to Manchester United. Still in the first 30 minutes, this is, bear in mind. I mean, what is this, man? Edison just bites the bait. We bring him out as far as possible, and then we just do a little dink. Is it too early to say it's game over, guys? I don't know, is it too early? But it feels like it. This, it truly does feel like it's game over now. Oh no. Oh my God. What is that? De Gea, how are you letting him beat you to the ball there? I'm not being funny. Both goals so far, De Gea should have done better. De Gea is letting us down big time. This should have been a nothing ball. De Gea should easily be beating him to the ball there. It's 3-2. What is this? Manchester City aren't going down without a fight. Can we send Ronaldo through once again? Can he make a run? Is he making a run? He is. Can we first time this? Oh, no, we can't. But, oh, what a save from Edison. Beautiful ball over by Bruno Fernandes. Ronaldo's very unlucky not to get his fourth goal there. But Edison does a freaking brilliant job of making that save there. That could easily be 4-0. Bruno, can you see Ronaldo? He does. Ronaldo, what can you do here? Can you do the... Oh my God! I cannot believe he actually just put that into the back of the net. What a goal! Guys, that was just a pipe dream shot. I genuinely did not expect that to go in. What a goal! Ronaldo is the GOAT on this game. Ronaldo is just unstoppable. Everything he touches turns to gold. Let's just take a look at this for a second. Brings it onto his right foot and he just finesses it straight into the top right hand side of the corner. What is this? Well, let's take a look. Oh my God. What a goal. What a goal. 4-2 at half time. And that is half time. We scored just before half time. What a goddamn game this has turned out to be, guys. I mean, it's quite an evenly contested game if you look at the stats. But honestly, Ronaldo is just unstoppable. Honestly, I'm so happy I bought him back to United. I'm so happy I bought him back to United. We go into the second half, 4-2 up. Let's finish the job. Oh my God, what a ball. Oh my God, can Ronaldo get his fifth goal? Can Ronaldo make it 5? Oh no, but Bruno Fernandes is there and he does not even try to tap it in. He absolutely nails it into the back of the net. Bruno, the Portuguese link in this game is unspoken. If it isn't Ronaldo, it's Bruno Fernandes. Ronaldo gets unlucky not to make it 5 himself here, but Bruno's not taking any chances there, and he makes it 5-2. It is United's game to lose right now. It is our game to lose right now. We got Sancho. Can we find Marcus? Oh my God, what a ball. Marcus, take the touch. He's going to finesse this, and it's just that easy. It is just that easy. The English link-up play there was beautiful. Jadon Sancho finds Marcus Rashford in acres of space. Marcus Rashford, calm and casually as you like, just slots it into the bottom right-hand side of the corner. It is well and truly game over now. United have won the Champions League. Look, sure, can he find Ronaldo? Ronaldo is through. Ronaldo is through. Can he make it? Seven! Oh, Edison makes a great save. He makes a great save, Edison does. Oh, bloody hell, where'd that come from? Jesus Christ. Oh, my God. I was I genuinely thought that was going to come to absolutely nothing then. Fair play. They snuck that right under my nose. Fair enough. Martial, can we get seven? We're going to feed Ronaldo. And he's got his fifth goal of the game. It is 7-3 in the Champions League final against Manchester City. You can't write this stuff, guys. You just can't write this stuff. And that should be the full-time whistle. Yes, it is. Manchester United have won the Champions League final. That was a lot easier than I thought. I thought Man City were going to give us a right good game there. But we just banged seven past them like they were nothing. Make sure you tell me what team you want me to do this with next. I'll make sure to get round to them as soon as possible. The next rebuild I do will be a very low budget squad. So stay tuned for that one. It's going to be a big video. If you did enjoy this video, be sure to leave a like and smash that subscribe button. It really does help with the YouTube algorithm. We're on the road to 1,000 subscribers as well. So every subscription helps along the way to achieving that goal. Thank you guys so much for watching, and until next time, I'll see you later.